Hello, welcome to this lecture video. In this video, I am going to explain problems of dielectric materials. So, what are the problems that we can see in dielectric materials chapter? So, which comes under module 5 of engineering physics prescribed by VTU. So, the first problem is, if NaCl crystal is subjected to an electric field of 1000 volt per meter and the resulting polarization is 4.3 × 10⁻¹⁸ coulomb per meter square, calculate the dielectric constant of NaCl. So here the given data is the value of capital E is equal to 1000 volt per meter and the polarization P is equal to 4.3 × 10⁻¹⁸ coulomb per meter square and epsilon 0 is equal to 8.854 × 10⁻¹² farad per meter square. So here we have to calculate what is epsilon r. So the formula used here is the polarization P is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r minus 1 into E. So on simplification, epsilon r is equal to 1 plus P by epsilon 0 into E. So substitute the value of P, epsilon 0 and E here. So after substituting the values, we are going to get the final result as 5.757. So that's what the value of epsilon r. Next problem is, what is the polarization produced in sodium chloride by an electric field of 6000 volt per mm if it has a dielectric constant of 5? So the given data here, it is E is equal to 600 volt per mm, that is equal to 600 × 10³ volt per meter, and epsilon r is equal to 5 and epsilon 0 is equal to 8.854 × 10⁻¹² farad per meter square. So what is the value of P here? So the formula used here is P is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r minus 1 into E. So that is nothing but 8.854 × 10⁻¹² into 5 minus 1 into 600 × 10³. So after simplification, the value of P is equal to 2.125 × 10⁻⁵ coulomb per meter square. The next problem is, an elemental solid containing 2 × 10⁻²⁷ atoms per meter cube shows an electronic polarizability of 2 × 10⁻⁴ farad meter square. Assuming a Lorentz force field to be operative, calculate the dielectric constant of the material. So here alpha E is equal to 2 × 10⁻⁴ farad meter square. Epsilon 0 is equal to 8.854 × 10⁻¹² farad per meter square, and the value of N is equal to 2 × 10⁻²⁸ atoms per meter cube. So here, what is the value of epsilon R? According to Clausius-Mosesti relation, we are having a formula, that is N alpha E by 3 epsilon 0 is equal to epsilon R minus 1 divided by epsilon R plus 2. By rearranging this formula, we are going to get epsilon R is equal to 1 plus 2 N alpha E by 3 epsilon 0 divided by 1 minus N alpha E by 3 epsilon 0. But the value of N alpha E by 3 epsilon 0 is calculated as 0.1506. Substitute the same in the above equation, then we are going to get the value of epsilon r is equal to 1.532. So this is the way of calculating the value of epsilon r. Now the another problem is, an elemental solid dielectric material has polarizability, that is 7 × 10⁻⁴ farad meter square. Assuming the internal field to be Lorentz field, calculate the dielectric constant for the material if the material has 3 × 10⁻²⁷ atoms per meter cube. So in this formula, the value of alpha E is given, that is equal to 7 × 10⁻⁴ farad meter square, and the value of epsilon 0, that is a constant, equal to 8.854 × 10⁻¹² farad per meter square, and the value of N is equal to 3 × 10⁻²⁷ atoms per meter cube. So what is the value of epsilon r? So as according to Clausius-Mosesti relation, we are having N alpha E by 3 epsilon 0 is equal to epsilon r minus 1 by epsilon r plus 2, So here the value of epsilon r is rearranged, and the value of n alpha e by 3 epsilon 0 is equal to 0.7906. Now in the equation, if you substitute the values, we are going to get the value of epsilon r is equal to 12.327, or that is equal to 12.33. So this is the way of calculating epsilon r by making use of Clausius-Mossetti equation. Now another problem, the dielectric constant of helium gas at NTP is 1.000684. Calculate the electronic polarizability of helium atoms if the gas contains 2.7 into 10 to the power of 25 atoms per meter cube, and hence evaluate the radius of helium atom. So here the given data is epsilon 0, that is 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12 farad per meter square, and the value of n is equal to 2.7 into 10 to the power of 25 atoms per meter cube. Epsilon r is equal to 1.000684, and what is the value of alpha e at r? Using the equation alpha e is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r minus 1 divided by n, that is substitute the value of epsilon 0 and epsilon r here. So finally the value of alpha e is equal to 2.243 × 10⁻⁴ farad meter square, and the value of radius r is equal to alpha e by 4 pi epsilon 0 volt to the power of 1/3. Substitute the value of alpha e whatever we got, and then epsilon 0 the equation. So finally the value of r is equal to 5.864 × 10⁻¹ meter. So this is the way of calculating the value of alpha e and r. Now another problem, the find the polarization produced in a crystal by an electric field of 500 volt per millimeter if it has a dielectric constant of 5. So here E is equal to 500 volt per millimeter, that is 500 × 10³ volt per meter, and epsilon r is equal to 5, and epsilon 0 is equal to 8.854 × 10⁻¹ farad per meter square. So what is the value of P here? So as per the equation, P is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r minus 1 into E. So substitute all the parameters in the formula. Finally, we are going to calculate the value of P is equal to 1.771 × 10⁻⁵ coulomb per meter square.